Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and place your hand over your heart for the number one song on iTunes, Amazon, and the Billboard charts. Justice for All, featuring President Donald J. Trump and the J6 Choir.
What is going on in America? That really happened. That was how he began his rally, was this song that they swear is winning on all the charts. And apparently some of it is true. That insane song is doing well. I forget exactly. I think it might be on iTunes or something, but it is not leading the Billboard Hot 100, you weirdo. That's not true. And the whole thing is even cultier than normal. And I'm not even talking about the tragic legacy of the city and the anniversary that they're having their rally on the eve of. But that's how we started. And honestly, it only got weirder from there, Francesca. Talking constantly about January 6th, almost like venerating the protesters that got arrested. And then moving into talking obviously about his legal predicament. He eventually declared himself probably the most innocent man in the history of our country, which is certainly a take. Everyone knows Tom Hanks is the most innocent man in the history of our country. But notably, as weird as some of it was, and we're gonna play some video for you in a bit, he did not double down on his threats of violence against Alvin Bragg, the DA investigating him in the hush money payments. He did not call for death and destruction in the way that he did. So maybe a little bit of the pushback, the dear God, what are you doing? You're making Ron DeSantis seem reasonable stuff might have gotten through to him, but what do you think?
I mean, I'm really digging the witch hunt signs in the back there. I will say that, yeah, so I mean, cool. That's cute. That's a little bonus. The song, which maybe we can't play for copyright purposes, really sucks. Like, it is bad. It is, in fact, it just sounds like, isn't it just the national anthem? It's just the national anthem with a choir.
I think Trump's voice is in it.
And him going, fake news, witch hunt, big hands, like horse face, never happy. You know what I mean? Like, you need to like step it up, you know? You need to get, it has to be like trappy, it's gotta be different. But anyway, also he's going more brassy than he usually is with the blonde right now. I feel like it's like usually like, oh, whiter. Now it's like, he needs some like that, like, I don't know, some color fading some, anyway, whatever, I'm fading. I don't know, man, let's keep on watching. You tell me how it was, John, what do you think?
We will, well, you know, I mean, as you said, if we could bring up this still, it is one thing to talk about a witch hunt during a rally, literally reminding people constantly of all the different legal challenges that you're facing. That's an interesting strategy, but they printed out all of those things in multiple colors, mind you. Like, they wanted everyone take this and never think about anything other than the fact that he's accused of many crimes.
Right.
That is such a weird strategy for a candidate. Like, I'm trying to come up with an example that's not awful to even discuss. I was thinking about what the guy who cheated on his wife while she had cancer. That's like, but imagine bringing that up constantly during your rally. I don't get it. And this guy is, despite all of this weird stuff, obviously he has a healthy lead, at least in national Republican polling, over Ron DeSantis. But it's the direction he went into. By the way, when it goes to the song, I'll say what I said before. John Edwards, thank you. Why was I blanking on Edwards? John Edwards, yeah, it's him.
Yeah,
Gingrich did a very similar thing, actually. It's both. There are multiple people who've had affairs while their wife had cancer. There's more than enough awfulness to go around. But thank you for that. When it comes to the song, anyone can make, like if there's a group of prisoners that want to raise awareness or money or whatever, they can make a song. That's not a problem. We can critique it as a piece of art, obviously. It's Donald Trump and the movement picking it up so much, taking the most disgusting moment perhaps from his presidency and the waning moments of his presidency and elevating it to a thing that everyone should worship. That's what bothers me.